Talk about the game and just kind of how tough it was down the stretch. You didn't sit in on the bench while the team's driving down the field. Well, I think that's always the hardest part. You're playing in the biggest game, you have a lead, but the ball's not in your hands. And so you're kind of at the mercy of everybody else. But, you know, we were confident at that point. We felt like we put ourselves in a position to win in the biggest game. We just had to tip our hat to the Steelers who came out and made some great plays. Now, I talked to you earlier. Fans, Kurt is on the fence about coming back. Let's hear it if you want to hear and see Kurt more to come back. You keep putting pressure on me, don't you? You know, I don't know. This year was great. I appreciated so much of what we accomplished this year. I love playing. I had a lot of fun. But I just got to take a little bit of time, and we'll see. I see I talked to Mr. Fitzgerald over here. Talk about his show. Just, you know, he and Anquan Boldin, two phenomenal wide receivers. Talk about the weapons that you had to work with this year.
Well, I have been so fortunate through my career to play with great receivers, great playmakers, and this year was no different. Anquan, Larry, to see what they do week in and week out, to see how they work, the plays that they make on the football field, I'm just always excited as a quarterback to know that I get to reap the benefits of all the great things that they do.
Let's hear the chant. Come back, Kurt.
Come back this year.
Come back, Kurt. Come back, Kurt. Come back, Kurt. We got Larry. Let's talk to the guy who's been the hottest receiver to play with. First of all, let's talk about your relationship with your father. You know, I always give your dad a lot of props for, you know, raising such a fine young man. Talk about your relationship with your dad.